Welcome to the first of two videos on how to perform partial fraction decomposition. This video will only focus on linear factors. Partial fraction decomposition is a process used to rewrite rational functions as a sum or difference of rational functions that are easier to integrate. In algebra class, we often took rational expressions and combined them by obtaining a common denominator to rewrite the sum or difference as a single rational expression. However, in calculus, if we have a rational function that's difficult to integrate, we can often write it as a sum or difference of simpler rational functions, making it easier to integrate. Let's take a look at how we're going to do this. First, if the degree of the numerator is greater than the degree of the denominator, we want to divide the denominator into the numerator to obtain a polynomial and a rational function where the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator. Once we have it in this form, we want to completely factor the denominator into prime linear or quadratic factors. For each linear factor, we'll have a numerator of a single variable a over the linear factor, and if the linear factor repeats, we would have to include additional fractions, picking up each additional linear factor over a new numerator until we've accommodated for all of the repeated linear factors. And if we have a quadratic factor, notice our numerator is now going to be in the form of bx plus c, so we have a binomial linear factor over the quadratic factor. And again, if it's repeated, we would have to include additional fractions with different numerators. And then lastly, once we have the partial fractions, we're going to multiply each fraction by the LCD, and the result is called the basic equation. And then we're going to solve the basic equation by determining the values of a, b, c, and so on, so that we can rewrite the rational function as a sum or difference of simpler rational functions. So let's go ahead and look at an example. We want to rewrite this as a sum or difference of simpler rational expressions. First thing we should check is that the numerator has a degree less than the denominator, which it does. So let's go ahead and factor this denominator. It's like we'll have x plus 5 times x minus 3. Notice we have two distinct linear factors. So that tells us that we're going to set this up as a over one of the linear factors, let's call it x plus 5, plus b over the other linear factor of x minus 3. Now we'll multiply every fraction by the LCD, which is x plus 5 times x minus 3. Notice on the left side, all of these factors simplify out. So we're left with 2 equals, here the x plus 5 simplify out, we're left with a times x minus 3, plus here the x minus 3 simplify out, and we're left with b times x plus 5. This is our basic equation. Let's go ahead and take this over to the next screen and continue. Now we need to solve this basic equation by determining the values of a and b. And it's a pretty straightforward process when we have linear factors. This equation is true for all values of x, which means we can pick any value of x we want to determine the values of a and b. Notice here if we let x equal 3, this factor here would be equal to 0. So let's go ahead and do that. If we let x equal 3, then we'd have 2 equals a times 3 minus 3, that would be 0, plus b times 3 plus 5, that'd be 8. Dividing both sides by 8, this tells us that b is equal to 1/4. Now looking at this binomial factor, let's let x equal negative 5. Remember, this is true for any value of x, so if we have linear factors, if we pick the zeros of the linear factors, it'll make finding the other variables very straightforward. So if x is negative 5, we'd have 2 equals, this would be a times negative 8 plus b times 0. So if we divide both sides by negative 8, we have a equals negative 1/4. So going back to the previous screen just for a moment, notice that we just found the value of a, which is the numerator of the fraction with the denominator of x plus 5, and b is the numerator of the fraction with the denominator of x minus 3. I copied it down here in red. So what we've just discovered is that if we decompose this fraction, it would be equal to, well, a is equal to negative 1/4, so we'd have negative 1 over 4 times x plus 5 plus b, which is positive 1/4, so we'd have 1 over 4 times x minus 3. This is the fraction decomposition of 2 over x squared plus 2x minus 15. Now, one thing you might have noticed already is we go back to the first screen that we said that this was equal to 1 over x plus 5 plus 1 over x minus 3, and this is different from what we just found. It doesn't mean what we found was wrong, it's just a different form. And just to verify, I'm going to show if we do combine these, we will get 2 over x squared plus 2x minus 15. So if we wanted to combine these, we would have to get a common denominator. That would be 4 times x plus 5 times x minus 3. This fraction is missing the x minus 3. This fraction is missing the x plus 5. So we'd have 4 times x plus 5 times x minus 3. And then we'd have negative x plus 3, and then x plus 5. As you can see, we'd have 8 over 4 times x plus 5 times x minus 3. And then lastly, this would simplify here to a 1 and to a 2, which does match the original rational expression. Let's go ahead and try one more. Again, the first step is to recognize that the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator. So now we're going to go ahead and factor the denominator completely. We have a common factor of x, and this is a perfect square trinomial, so we'll have x times x plus 1 times another factor of x plus 1. So we have 3x squared plus 3x plus 1 over x times x plus 1 squared. It's going to equal, notice all the factors are linear, so we'll have a single variable in the numerator. We'll have a over x plus b over x plus 1. And since this factor is repeated, we need another fraction where we have c over the quantity x plus 1 to the second. Now we're going to multiply everything in the equation by x times x plus 1 squared. Notice on the left, everything simplifies out. And we're left with 3x squared plus 3x plus 1 would equal, notice here only the factor of x simplifies out, so we're left with a times the quantity x plus 1 squared plus, here notice only one factor of x plus 1 simplifies out, so we have b times x plus 1 plus, here two factors of x plus 1 simplify out, and we're left with cx. Okay, this is our basic equation. Now we need to determine the values of a, b, and c by selecting values of x. And we can select any value of x that we wish, but selecting these zeros of these linear factors should make it a lot easier. So let's set x equals 0. If x equals 0, on the left we'd have 0 plus 0 plus 1, so we'd have 1 equals, here we'd have 1 squared times a, that would be a. Well, here's an x, so that would be 0, and here's an x, so that would be 0. So we know that a is equal to 1. Now let's use x equals negative 1. If x equals negative 1, here we'd have 3 plus negative 3, that's 0, plus 1, so we'd have 1 equals, if x is negative 1, this would be 0. If x is negative 1, this would be 0. And if x is negative 1, this would be negative c. So if 1 equals negative c, we know that c equals negative 1. And now we need to determine the value of b. So we need to select another value of x, but we can also use the fact that we know a is 1 and c is negative 1. So let's let x equal 1. If x is 1, on the left we'd have 3 plus 3 plus 1, that'd be 7 equals, here we'd have 1 plus 1, that'd be 2 squared, that'd be 4, times a, but now we know a is 1, so that would be 4, plus, and when x is 1, here we'd have 1 plus 1, that'd be 2, times 1 times b, that'd be 2b, and then we have c times x, but we know c is negative 1, so we have negative 1 times 1, that would be negative 1. So it looks like we have 4 minus 1, that'd be 3, subtracting 3 on both sides, we have 4 equals 2b, So it looks like B equals 2. Okay, we have everything we need. We're going to go ahead and rewrite this partial fraction decomposition here with the values of A, B, and C as the numerators. Let's go ahead and do that on the next screen. Okay, here's how we started. We have this rational expression. We rewrote it as a sum of these three fractions, and then we determined the values of A, B, and C from the basic equation. So we have found that this rational expression is equal to 1 over x plus 2 over x plus 1. And since C is negative, we'll have minus 1 over x plus 1 squared. This is the partial fraction decomposition of this rational expression. In the next video, we'll take a look at how to perform partial fraction decomposition when we have quadratic factors. I hope you found this helpful.